Menthol, how crazy was that show you were showing me clips of? Like, is it as nuts as that transformation sequence?
Oh yeah, the whole thing.
Like, oh,
that's fucking awesome.
There's actually another series.
Yeah.
It had two seasons and a movie that was about the same level of crazy.
Really? I watched like the first few episodes of Amazons and like. I had to stop because I was on a car ride and it was very dark. Like in the show, it was dark, but it was like bright outside. I was driving down to Florida with my dad.
Oh, sorry, you were talking about that other shit. No, you were talking about the one.
Oh yeah,
Inoue. No, I don't know. I
haven't
watched it. I thought you were
talking
about fucking Black Sun. We was watching some of that earlier.
Oh, okay. I was like, what? Wait. Amazons is brutal. Like I remember, like. Tearing parts off of monsters. Yeah.
I legit confused you for fucking saxophone.
Oh, okay. That's fair.
Like,
you should feel very privileged, saxophone. You got compared to a handsome man. Or feel devastated. I don't know. Some people have either way on me. But, no, I was like sitting there and I'm like, okay, this is weird. Oh, no. Okay, he's got a. Hands-free device, and that's his transformation. Now he's a robot. What? No, why? Like, it just felt like so much, like, why would you do this? Like, just over and over, why did you do this? It looked cool, though.
Right. It's just bizarre as shit. I just happened to find that on Twitter today and looked into the name of it. And apparently the name is inspired by the hex code for the fucking color pink, because he's just all about that pink decade shit.
Oh, yeah, hey. I still. Oh, yeah.
What is the game currently going on right now?
Yeah.
Alright, pause when it's done. You continue.
Yeah, so, he definitely looked like decayed-y, I guess. Like, before he transformed, he reminded me of, like, almost like Violent Emotions style decayed. Do you remember where he had, like, the weird curly hair?
Yeah.
Or almost, maybe like Ankh, too. I don't know. I got vibes.
Bonk.
You get a lot better at goalie. Yeah.
It is just blowing all our fucking cooldowns.
Bonk. I can't believe it fell for the exact same shot twice.
I haven't watched Dyrus in a while. And so I asked my friend who has, like, what's his stuff like lately? He's like, oh, Dyrus is always just kind of depressed. I'm like, oh, that's too bad. And then I go here, I unlock the emote for him. I was like, oh, it's just depressed Dyrus. I don't know how I feel about that.
Man, I'm excited. I finished my video, so whenever you guys are done, we can show it off.
Yeah, let me finish this one real quick.
Yeah, fuck, that little thing I caught behind you.
Yeah.
If you or Sax ever seen that on the field, kick the ball to it. Because that automatically pulls it directly towards my location. And it doesn't have crazy high speeds.
Yeah, this Julia is not worried about being a goalie. She's too busy trying to take me out, which I'm kind of trying to do.
It's really funny listening to you and Menthol complain about the fighting.
Oh no, she's not goalieing. She's just straight up chasing me every time. It's kind of funny as shit, so I'm trying to play it against her.
Well, these other two think that they're goalie on our team because they won't leave me alone. They won't leave the crease.
Oh, look at that.
There we go.
Dabbing in the
void. The fighting doesn't bother me. You have to remember this day that the goal is like to make goals. So the fighting is like secondary.
Exactly. Yeah. The fighting should be if you just happen to see a nigga that's low on health, snipe him.
That's it.
Right, I'm
like certain characters on certain maps are doing better than others.
Alright, Gilliam, are you doing a run right now?
Yeah, I'm on song.
What are you playing?
Something ancient.
Why are you playing the... Did you pause like Indiana Jones?
I'm doing a speed one, dude.
Oh, okay, my bad.
He's playing Big Joey Slapnuts.
Big Joey Slapnuts. Yeah, this is the entire... What's his name? Short round. This is the short round only run of Indiana Jones.
This is Snake's only run.
No time for love, Dr. Jones! Just slaps him around the balls.
Here, you have to play Lego Indiana Jones, but if you see a single Lego snake, you die. No, you have to put a blindfold on anytime there's a snake in a level.
Anytime you see a snake in the level, they release real snakes into your room.
They put real snakes. They release the lions.
The lions?
Old video, I've seen many times before, but it's still one of the funniest things, is just Steve Irwin on TV getting bit by a live snake, and he's like, oh, yeah, it's on me. Alright,
yeah,
hold
on.
Oh, he let go. And he's just like, he's so nonchalant about it. He's like, oh, yep, yeah, it's got me.
It kind of has. This has like a casual chuckle with it.
I guarantee it doesn't hurt. Those fangs are definitely so sharp, it really doesn't hurt.
I think it would,
bro. You take a needle and it still hurts. It does kind of hurt.
So there's two things about it. A, you know, snakes got fangs. The snakes also have, like, most of them have another set of teeth. They're there just to hold on. Like, they're not big, but they're needle point. And it trust me, if somebody's been snake bit before, it hurts.
Oh, okay, never mind.
It's like, because if they just kind of pop you, it's not quite as bad. But if they get on there and hold on to you, yeah, it's bad.
Like,